Could you describe prayer when sitting and laying down at home or in Jamaat?
With Fikr Medical, our question comes from Bosnia. Can you describe prayer with regards to sitting or laying down when a person is at home? I suppose that the question is talking about in a state of sickness or in the state of traveling or, unfortunately, but it is a reality, in the state of a Muslim being tortured, a Muslim being in captivity, in which there are many Muslims as we speak who are in captivity and being tortured. May Allah release them and help them. Regardless whether they have done wrong or not, they're still what?
Muslims.
And the people who have captured them and imprisoned them and are torturing them are not Muslims. And they are not dealing with those Muslims who may be astray or have done wrong according to the what? The Sharia. Everyone understand that? Just because a Muslim does wrong doesn't mean that he's just now violated as a human being, let alone as a what?
Muslim.
A Muslim. Are they giving him a quick, easy, painless death? Or are they torturing him psychologically? Molesting him and doing all types of things to his mind and his body. And the rest of the world, and we just sit back and drink our tea and say nothing. While these Muslims are being tortured and kept in all types of inhumane conditions, and we just what? Say, oh, well, that's what they get. They shouldn't have done this or they shouldn't have said that. Until it happens to your son or your brother or your father. All right? May Allah help us all. So with regards to making salah, sitting down or laying down, whether you're sick, whether you're traveling, whether you're in prison, etc., then the prayer of the one who's sick is based off of ease and facilitation. It's based off of ease and facilitation. It is not based off of stringent, rigid rules, like one who's standing. So if you can pray with your legs crossed like this, then you do that. If you wish to sit like you're in what? Jilsa, then you do that. If you have to sit with your legs straight out facing the Qibla or your knee, however you got to do it, sitting down, then you what? You do it. What's the best way to sit? Some of the ulama of Islam say, some of them say that it is a tarabbur. As we would say in our colloquial or common terms, Indian style. Indian style, right? Cross leg or four legged, we say Indian style. And FYI, as a fa'idah, if you study about the Lenape Indians or the Delaware Indians, you'll find some very interesting information about where the term Indian style comes from. And if they did or didn't sit like this and why. Very, very, very interesting scientific fact with regards to sitting, what?
Indian
style. Al-Muhim. Some of the ulama say that this is best. And others, they say rather Jilsa is best. But they don't agree that they're all what? They don't disagree that they're all what? Permissible based off of the need and the facilitation and ease of the what? Of the ill person, all right? That's with regards to sitting down. And the same applies to lying down. If you can face the Qibla, if you can sit on your lay on your right side, that's one thing. If you can't, then on your back with your feet towards the Qibla. Whatever you have the ability what? To do. That's with regards to the ill Muslim. And being ill doesn't mean that you're about to die, but it means it causes you pain to stand up or pain to sit up. Even if you can bear it, but it's what? It's painful. And that's not what the Prophet ﷺ meant when he said to Imran ibn Hussein, فَإِلَّمْ تَسْتَطِعْ, if you can't. He didn't mean if it's impossible, but he meant if you can't do it unless you have a great deal of what? Hardship and pain. Then do it sitting, then do it lying, etc. All right? So on the sitting down, lying down for someone who's sick and ill, do what's the easiest. What's the best way? Perhaps one may say is sitting what? Like this, quote unquote. One may say that, and others may say it's what? The sitting of what? Of jilsa, like you're in tashahud. Everyone understand this? As far as if you're traveling, then it's a bit different. Oftentimes you're sitting on a plane or a seat on a train or something, you don't have the ability to cross your legs, and your feet will be on the floor. So you neither have the jilsa position or the Indian style position. Everyone understand this? So you're going to do it the best way that you what? That you can. And obviously the fiqh of the time, combining the salah, standing up, getting your bags in the airport, airport security holding you up, etc. When will Asr go out? Should I make it on a plane or should I wait until I land? You get off the train, you get off the plane, you may get held up. It may be a traffic jam and you may not have the ability to use the bathroom and you may miss what?
Salah.
So sometimes it's best just to make the prayer sitting down and combine it what? Sitting down while you're traveling. Everyone understand this? Everyone clear on this or not? As far as someone who's in jail or someone who's being tortured or something like this, then of course, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا. Fear Allah the best way you know how, even if you don't have wudu. you can't make tayammum. And the correct view, and Allah knows best from among the ulama of Islam, is that inna faqid at-tahurain, the mas'al is called faqid at-tahurain. He who has neither of the two types of purification makes the salah hasab halihi, according to his condition, and he does not have to make the prayer up. He doesn't have to make up the prayer. And the same applies to sitting down, not facing the qibla, and times of need and necessity. That's obviously in what?
Brief.
In brief. Wallahu alam.